Welcome back to frickin' what? Sapara? I still don't know how to frickin' pronounce it. Don't question me. And this time, we're gonna continue. She offered to pick me up from the station, but I refused. I couldn't impose like that. Oh, that button makes that disappear. Thank you for telling me now. Well, I'm sure I won't get lost as long as I have a map. Okay. So I'm guessing we're on road 134? Who the fuck are you? God damn it, triple question mark. You keep on showing up. In the vast majority of this channel, you're always here. Why? It's always like this. You always show up out of nowhere. Who are you? I don't know who you are. No, I don't want to use that search engine. I know Yahoo. Not bad. Used it a few times. Who are you again? I beg your pardon. I hope she had mistaken me for someone else, but that wasn't likely given how she called me by my first name. Perfect. Okay. Who are you exactly? No, I don't want to remember. I've had to hit my head against a wall 300 times in the past 10 seconds. Am I supposed to remember? I am facing serious whiplash. Okay, I'm gonna go with that. I'm not taking that out. I'm sorry. Perhaps I should have tried a little harder to remember. But I gave up when I saw her in the maid uniform. Fair enough. Good. Fuck! I have a sister! Big sister? I'm an only child, though. Unless... I use Sakura's Oni-chan. Okay. Okay, you have a lot of energy. This is gonna be amusing. This is coming from someone who had a lot of energy. Sakura Nomori-san. Or Sakura's Oni-chan. As I once called her. Was my second cousin when I was left all alone in this town with nowhere to go. She and her family took me in. Okay. I stared at my hand. Why did I skip that? I thought there was more. It had been 7 years since this girl who was 1 year older than me had taken this small hand of mine and led me to all sorts of different places. Something has to be up. I'll be back. I'm back! Turns out it was nothing, really. I just wanted to check what it was. Either way, we're going back to the story. As far as I was concerned, she was more of a sister than a distant relative. Okay. At least I vaguely remember. I mistook you for someone else. No, you're just beyond recognition. Screwed up that word. Am I not supposed to be disappointed? Do I need to be bringing up freaking compliments? Wearing an outfit like that will do that to a person. Fair enough. Plus, it's been 7 years. Do you expect me to remember who you are? Like, come on! That's not something you wear just to stand out. Oh, I do it to fucking mess with people. Screw you. Specifically, if I wanted to screw with someone. I don't care if I haven't seen him in 7 years or 3 days. I'll wear it just to mess with them. Knowing how I am. Fucking hell. Fair enough. Your job? Now I have to mind! Please continue! I need context! I am amused! Okay. Got like half an hour. Please go on. Sounds like a plan. There was more I wanted to ask, but I was going to stick out like a sore thumb if I stood in front of the station talking to a woman in a maid outfit. Fair enough. No. I will bring nothing but spite. Please don't call me that. No. Please continue. We went out of the station, its east exit, into a large avenue, and continued south on of my map. If my map was correct, we should be heading towards the beach. Okay, I like you guys already. You actually took the fucking time to fucking animate that. You guys did well. You guys fucking took the time. Fair enough. That won't stop me from trying to find the alleyways. Cool. Now we know there's a shrine. Is that going to be important? I see. Either way, Sakura Oni-san, aren't you going to change out of those clothes? I was grateful for her guide tour of this unfamiliar town, but I was too embarrassed to consider it. I have a feeling people watching this would immediately love for me to say, oh, hell yes. As tempting as it may be, I would have to edit that out. I'm not even kidding. It does seem rather tempting. Nobody said anything like that. Fair enough. don't know how to process that exactly. Don't do that either. You really want to go with this, don't you? That question, as a man, all I can say is no comment. No, no, screw you. I want to know. What are your options? God damn it. I am more amused than just doing this shit. Like, God damn. You're thinking about that, aren't you? Were you always like this? I can tell you, I'm not cool. I'm freaking like a Looney Tunes character. I'm freaking insane. Like, that's the main thing people keep on telling me, that I'm fucking insane. Or just insane. Or unhinged. Or anything around those words. Yep, that's pretty much how everyone sees me. Just not cool. I think only one female, one chick actually said that to me. Only one. And that was in high school. Dear God. I could tell she hadn't taken care of me. But I'd completely forgotten any specific details. Oh, yeah. Fair enough. I still. Why am I forgetting that the A means autosave? I've seen that a few times. And yet I'm forgetting about it. She smiled as if briefly amusing herself within her memories. Good. 7 years ago, my family and I once lived a fair distance away from Kanto. But after my sickly father passed away, we returned to Kamakura, where my mother's family lived. However, during our travels, our ship accidentally ran aground and capsized. Fortunately, there were a few casualties. Unfortunately for us, we were included in that minority. We missed the lifeboats and drifted away. Shortly, therefore, we had washed ashore on Kamakura Beach in a comatose state. In the end, 7 years passed, and Mother never regained consciousness. Shoot. I suffered no physical ailments, but I was left with one important imprintment. I had lost all my memories from before and during the incident. I've heard all about it from other people, though. You know what? I think this is the best time to kind of end the episode. For obvious reasons. But I hope all you guys have great love time, great day two, and yes, I will continue from here. I hope. So, see you guys next time. Like, question, what the fuck's gonna happen?